So we're in the beginning of the summer, and we've had some mild weather. And you can see my hydrangeas, they want to start growing already. And that's where your flower comes from next year. And we can see that in here. These little nubs here, we want to protect them. So I'm going to go ahead and pack these in with some hay. And I'll do some other things. So right now I have a thing of hay here, and I'm going to pack them in for the winter. And hopefully we're going to get our second year hydrangeas to flower that second year, which is hard to do. So I loosely packed that hay around our new propagated hydrangeas. And of course in the springtime, in the summer, I'll update you, and if I was able to get those second year hydrangeas to flower, which I haven't been able to do in the last couple of years. And also here, you can see that I have dug in an area here. I've dug the plants in below ground level to try and keep them a little bit warmer. So they're actually below ground. And also, if you have a plant that is like a single container, you want to dig them into the ground to protect their roots. Otherwise, they probably wouldn't survive the harsh winter. I also use the weed block on some of my hydrangeas that are have already been in the ground or established, and I just cover them and put some bricks to hold the weed block on. And I'm not done with this. I still have to cover the back side of it, but I've also used this to protect them a little bit in the winter. And of course leaves. I use leaves sometimes. One thing I don't like about the leaves is they get wet, and they don't dry out quickly like the straw does. So the leaves have a tendency to rot or rot the plant, and you have to pile a lot of leaves on there, and they get wet and packed on. So I like to stay away from leaves, but I do use them from time to time when I have to.